Our next storyteller is Zach. Zach was a, wrote this down on the wrong spot. Zach was an English teacher in Nicaragua from 2013 to 2015. Zach? Oh, there you are.
All right, so like first time storyteller going after the third time storyteller, I'm set up for disaster here. Thank you, Sean. No. Hey y'all, I'm originally from Ohio, but I'm fairly new, about a year and a half into Houston. So I was a little bit nervous for this, but then I was like, y'all are my people, so I'm awfully excited to be here. That's right. Yeah. Wow, how to follow story from the 60s, that's wild. Okay, so I served, 2013 to 2015, in Nicaragua, the land of lakes and volcanoes, la tierra de lagos y volcanes, for those of you that want to know Spanish. So something that I learned so many things and could talk about so many things, but I think what I wanted to focus on is how Nicaraguans are late to everything. Absolutely everything. They call it La Hora Nica, because the Nicaraguans and Nicaragüenses, they call them Nicas. In Costa Rica, they call them Ticos. They have names for people in countries. But in Nicaragua, we would latch onto this in our Spanglish, like, you know, Nica time, right? And so if you're, teaching English as a foreign language, TEFL Volunteer. I was a teacher trainer. Everything Peace Corps does is, I'm preaching to the choir here, you want it to be sustainable. So I train teachers, so instead of just teaching by myself. And so a lot of the time I'd make workshops and, you know, facilitate stuff for English teachers to work on their curriculum building and their confidence in speaking English, et cetera. If I wanted to teach them something at 3 o'clock, I had to tell them that it started at 1:30. Otherwise, there was just no chance that anybody would be on time. And so I like to think about, okay, so like, where's the root in that? Like, so what, why are they late to everything? And my best guess is because they ran into people that they knew on the way to wherever they were going. And that's pretty common, because in a developing country, you can't have, like, what we have is like a house and a yard and a house and a yard, and you're spread out. You have to push everything really close together. So it's like house. You're immediately seeing all the people that you spend every day with all the time. And when you see them, you talk to them. And it's actually something extremely beautiful about the culture, because the emphasis that they place on relationships is unbelievable. And I noticed this because when I saw somebody I knew, if we were walking past each other in opposite directions, what Nicaraguans say is they don't say hi, they actually say goodbye. I'm serious. You're walking the opposite, you're like, adios, yeah. You're saying goodbye to somebody. And it's because if you were to say hi, like we do, like imagine you're walking by somebody, you know, hey, how you doing? Good to see you. Have a great day. Okay, bye. Yeah. You know, that you're actually sort of starting a conversation by saying, hi, like, what's going on? But there, they're immediately like, no, this isn't one of those moments. This is a goodbye moment, like, goodbye, adios, right? But if it is a hi moment, then you say hi, you actually have a conversation. You have a real conversation, you spend 15 minutes, you spend 20 minutes, you talk to them, you have a connection with the other person, because you know them and you're investing in that conversation. And honestly, I just like, I think about here, you know, whenever I see somebody I know, what is the shortest amount of time you can spend on a conversation with somebody that's still socially acceptable? What, like 3 seconds, 4 seconds? Hey, good to see you. How you doing? All right. Yeah, I got to go to this thing. Okay, bye. Done, right? That is like that's not how it plays. In Nicaragua, yeah, you just say adios. Like you're like, no, this is not a conversation. But if you have a conversation, you have it. So this is my theory. The emphasis that they place on relationships, that's what makes them late to everything, because they're running into people they know and they're having conversations with each other. But also, the way they see it is they're like, okay, this conversation deserves its moment. You are a relationship, you are someone that's important to me, so I'm gonna give you this moment that you deserve. And it's not just people that works, it's also meals. They give meals the moment that they deserve. They're like, you know, this is lunch. Like, we're gonna eat lunch, and lunch is a big meal. It's very similar in Europe, and I've been other places that, you know, lunch is that meal, right? Dinner is just sort of something you eat to keep yourself nourished. So this happened to me once in training. it was a Saturday, and I talked to other Peace Corps volunteers, and we were going to meet at La Laguna de Apoyo, which is a lagoon that is once was a crater of a volcano that erupted its final eruption and filled up with water. And we were like, what? Like, can we swim in it? And you could. You absolutely could. And you still can. If you guys ever go to Nicaragua, go there. It's amazing. And there's a trail that takes you all the way down to the bottom, and you get in, and you should swim in the crater. And we were like, all right, we're going to meet up at 1 o'clock, and we're going to hike down. We're going to spend the day and then catch one of the last buses back, right? Well, in my town, the distance between the volcano and where I was living, it was about 45 minutes. And the buses ran every 45 minutes, I think, because there was literally just two buses. It was like a cycle. And so the bus that I had to catch was the 12 o'clock bus. Well, 12 o'clock is during lunch. So I went up to my host sister, who is my closest relationship with a family of 15, that I lived in a house of 15 people. She was my closest relationship, and I knew she was going to cook. So I was like, look, I got to catch this bus. I need to meet my friends. Like, I'm going to go swim in Laguna de Apoyo. She's like, yeah, absolutely. You know, she's a good ambassador to the country. Like, that's beautiful. You should totally go. I'm making arroz aguado. It's like a stew sort of rice. She's like, it's fairly easy to make. I got to run some errands this afternoon. Like, I'll have it ready. Don't worry about it. Yeah, exactly. Like, I got to do things too, right? I'm going to make it quick too. And the word that she kept using was tranquilo, like tranquilo. It's like my favorite word, honestly. It's just like, al suave, like relax. It's chill, right? Tranquilo. Tranquilo, Zach, you'll get to the Laguna, no problem. I'm going to make lunch, and it's going to be made early. So I'm like, all right, I got to catch this 12 o'clock bus. So 11 o'clock runs around, she's cooking. I'm like, sweet, so I'm going to have this soon. And she's like, absolutely, tranquilo, Zach, tranquilo, you're going to be fine. I'm like, all right, great. So then 11:15 comes around. I'm like, all right, hopefully soon, because I'm going to have to eat. And she's like, tranquilo, it's almost ready. 11:30, tranquilo, Zach, tranquilo, it's going to be ready. I really got to eat. 11:45, I'm like, Yoli, I got to eat. I have to eat this right now. Like, otherwise, I'm going to miss this bus. And she's like, tranquilo, Zach, it's hot. Like it's really hot. It's got to cool down. Like, you'll be fine. And so then it's like, you know, 5 minutes. I'm like, I literally have to catch a bus in 12 minutes. Like, I need to eat this food. I was like, can I just put it in Tupperware and, like, get it to go? And she's, like, looking at me like I just spoke in a foreign language, which I wasn't, actually. I was speaking in Spanish. I'm like, no, I see it. Tupperware is hanging on the wall. Can I just put it in Tupperware? And she's just like, no, Zach, no, that is not how this works. Like, you're going to eat your lunch. I'm like, but I got to catch this bus. She's like, tranquilo, there's another bus. I'm like, I know there's another bus, but it comes 45 minutes later. I'm meeting my friends at 1 o'clock, and she's like, she just does not comprehend. I'm like, you're not listening to the words that are coming out of my mouth. So I just get the Tupperware. I just grab it, and I start walking over, and she, like, catches it, like, grabs it. And I'm like, what are you? And she's like, no, like, you will eat your lunch, and you will like it, and you will relax. And I'm like, no, I gotta go. Like, what are you talking about? I'm like fighting with her, and I'm sort of laughing, actually, because I'm like, this is hilarious. Like, Yoli's a close, you know, my closest relationship within this family, right? I'm like, this is not real. Like, this is funny, right? And I turn and I look, and my host mom is like standing right there. And like, my host brothers are like walking over, and the kids are like, what's with the gringo? What's this deal? And I'm like, no. So eventually she sort of like, fine, whatever. And I serve it, and I get it to go, and I'm out. I catch the bus. I'm running. I get on it. I go to the volcano. I hike to the bottom. I swim. It's a great time. I get back. Yoli is pissed. She is so mad at me, and she's giving me this, like, death stare as I walk in, and I'm sort of just like, oh, my God, you wouldn't believe the day I just had. I saw monkeys. I swam. It was amazing. I'm like, why are you mad at me? Like, I haven't been here all day. Like, you're already mad at me. Like, what's going on? And she's still upset. She's still upset from that interaction. And you know, I had to have a conversation with her, and I'm like, all right, well, what was it, you know, I'm sorry, but you have to understand where I was coming from, right? And she's like, Zach, everything deserves its time, and lunch deserved its time, and she had just spent all that time making that meal for me, and she was looking forward to sitting down, eating a meal that I had never tried before in her culture, you know, her recipe, to sit and eat a meal that she made for me with her and spend that time with her. And I was unwilling to do that because of my own agenda and my, you know, all this America, it was like Mr. America just telling me, I gotta go, you know. And she goes, Zach, that volcano crater is not going anywhere. That's gonna be there whenever you get there. And your friends, you know, okay, so they're Americans, so they're probably not gonna wait for you. But there's a path, there's one path that leads to the volcano. And you could find the one path and walk down it, and they're gonna be there. Because there's one crater, one path that leads to one crater, you would have found them. They're still gonna be there. Tranquilo, al suave, relax. Everything deserves its time. And I just so resonated with me, because I just think, you know, I've tried to live like that, I think, since. I'm late to meetings. I literally came here from work. I mean, I'm late to things. I'm late responding to emails. But I'd like to think it's because in the moment, I'm giving the moment that it deserves. So I'm really happy I'm giving this moment to you guys and with you guys. So thank you. This was important.